Hello, I'm Jeff from Nerd Park, and I'm going to do a review series of the TV show Fargo. They are currently going on season 2. If you haven't seen season 1, I highly recommend you go watch it. It starred Martin Freeman and Billy Bob Thornton, and it's based off of the Coen brothers' film Fargo. It's not a retelling of that story. To go into too much detail would spoil it, but it does emulate the Coen brothers' direction. It was just a fantastic piece of storytelling. Now, you don't necessarily need to watch season 1 to watch season 2. It's in the same world, but set during different times. There's only one character that's on season 1 that carries over to season 2. Lou Sulverson in season 1 was played by Keith Carradine, and season 2 is played by Patrick Wilson. Now, this is a prequel of sorts to season 1, and it's set in, like, 1979, I believe. I've been really excited about this, and because season 1 was so good, and like, how are they going to be able to top that? Well, if the rest of the seasons like episode 1 was of season 2, we're in for a real treat. But since this is the beginning of season 2, I figure I will not divulge much information. The dialogue is fantastic. That's one thing that separates this from many other shows. It has that Coen brothers tone. They just have this really weird dialogue that normally you wouldn't hear from come out of anyone's mouth. One of my favorites was, "You're a comic and a piece of bubblegum." I've already starting to really love these characters within one episode. They're really establishing how the personalities, especially Lou Sulverson, played by Patrick Wilson. I already like him already. Even though I know his character a little bit beforehand in season one when he's played older, but there's just a charm that you just can't help but admire. Also, other characters, we have Ted Danson playing Hank Larson, who is a police officer as well, but also happens to be Patrick Wilson, Lou Sulverson's father-in-law, and their partners. That should be a very interesting dynamic going on between those two. You have Jesse Plemons from Breaking Bad, and recently Black Mass, if you haven't seen that movie, he's in that. He plays the character of Ed Blomquist, who works at a butcher shop, and he gets tangled up in a big mess because of his wife, who is played by Kristen Dunst, and she plays his wife Peggy. And a standout of this episode was Kieran Culkin, Macaulay Culkin's younger brother, who the only other movie I can remember seeing him in was Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. But he had a very entertaining character, Rye Gerhart, or Gerhart, I think. And I don't want to go too much into it, but we kind of got like our Sopranos of Fargo here. I actually like Nick Offerman's in it. I hope he keeps continuing to be in this show. I don't know how big of a role his character is going to be, but he plays the character of Carl Weathers, very big conspiracy theorist. It was a little weird not seeing him without his mustache. A little odd. Yeah, there's a big scene involving the Waffle House. It was pretty non-stop edge of your seat action going on in that scene. And there's a lot of questions too. And there's something that they hinted at in this episode that kind of threw me off, but I'm really intrigued about it. Let's just say it involves some lights. That's my little hint. I'm really excited about this season. I hope you enjoyed this review. This is Jeff from Nerd Park, and stay nerdy, eh?